boss. This week's income from the sponsors has cleared, and we're making good profit against our running costs.
We can spend any extra money that you secured on perks. Each of these perks benefit both you and your current team. They stay with you, so they'll make you a more attractive prospect in future negotiations.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today.
A Mercedes, Verstappen,
and Valtteri Bottas. Goodbye for now then, but we're really just getting started. Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
Fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. Great qualifying session. Are you feeling safer ahead of the pack? What was the secret of your qualifying pace? Did you feel that things went well for you today? Secret ingredient for your performance today? Great, well that's everything.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
Formula One returns to Sao Paulo once again with the stage set for what promises to be another classic Brazilian Grand Prix. Sebastian Vettel famously clinched his third championship here in 2012. And in 2016, Max Verstappen treated us to one of the finest wet weather drives of all time. Interlagos, always a very special race here in Brazil. It's a 2.7-mile circuit with 9 lefts and 6 rights for a total of 15 corners. Fastest lap today should have an average speed of around 135 miles per hour, if, of course, the weather stays dry until the end of the Grand Prix. And so, for one final time this season, Anthony Davidson joins me in the commentary box.
Well, the winter break is looming once again. I doubt many of those teams already have their eyes firmly on next season. But there's still work to be done here. Still championship positions to decide, which can make a big difference to the prize money. So no one's going to be taking their foot off the throttle just yet.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. It's the owner driver in pole position then, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Hamilton, Charles Leclerc and Ricciardo, Albon, Vettel, Norris and Esteban Ocon, Sainz, Kvyat, Pierre Gasly and Raikkonen, Perez, Giovinazzi, Lance Stroll and Kevin Magnussen, De Vries, Grosjean, Latifi and George Russell ends our grid lineup. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today? And so the celebrations begin, and well-earned they are indeed. It may have looked simple at times, but as any racing driver will tell you, competing at this level, at the very top, is anything but simple. There's no catching them now then. We have a new World Drivers Champion. Victory today then, but bittersweet emotions I'm sure, as the championship slips through their fingers. Even so, what a fantastic final race of the season this was. Talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalize on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everyone at the team. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Difficult call, but I'd like to say Esteban Ocon. He's just so gifted at getting the most out of his tyres, and he showed that today. Let's give it to Esteban Ocon. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
So then, Ferrari have now moved out of sight and out of reach. It's another triumph for the Italian team as they claim the World Constructors' Championship.
I know that's at odds with the official decision, but I think they deserve some recognition on a day where both of these drivers are at the top of their game.
Well, and an end to another...
So that was an exciting race from our perspective. Let's have yours. It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? You left a lot of paint on the walls today. Were you struggling for grip, or did you just misjudge some corners? It wasn't the cleanest race today, was it? Appreciate your time.
window for driver contract negotiations has opened. You're not currently in a rivalry. Sooner or later, you'll probably be asked by the media who you consider to be your rival. Think carefully who you select. While you will receive a claim for beating them, you'll lose a claim if you fail to do so.
Thanks so much for the invitation to your HQ. Let's have a little chat about the team's performance this season. You've managed to get your team into a good position. How long do you think it will be before you can challenge the big three? Your second driver really seems to be improving at a rapid pace. How dedicated are they? Do you see your relationship with your second driver being long-term, or will you be looking for someone else if you're successful? Sponsors seem to be climbing over one another to get their name onto your car. What do you plan on investing that extra money into? You've got one of the top teams in the Constructors' Championship. What's your secret to scoring those points? Thanks so much, as ever, for your time. It's hugely appreciated.
Hey boss, I think we could better manage our time by organising some team activities. Head to the activity screen to see what we have available. much as I love seeing big numbers on the books, we don't get any benefit from leaving it in the bank. Let's spend some of this cash.